Have we lost focus? No, we're right here. We're right here. Right here now. Haven't lost it. Okay, so that's right away feeling of reassurance. No concerns. Now, using words is very clumsy. So you have to blend the words with your own, with your understanding and clarity. Don't get stuck on the words. Trust it. Trust it. Trust yourself. Trust what's being said. What it's pointing to. So I asked this morning for some guidance, and I received it, of course. And I was saying, how can I get back into abidance? How can I get back into abidance? And the response was, you never left. I said, well, something pulled me out of it. No, nothing pulled me out of it. And so the practice is to say, I did not leave abidance. So I started to practice in this way. And then this brought up the whole non-dual clarity about what the non-dual message. There's no enlightenment to seek at all. We never left reality. So how could we need to add something to that? Do we need to add enlightenment of what? What is enlightened? There must be something that left reality to be enlightened. Nothing ever left reality. We never left our freedom. We have everything because we're free. There's nothing we can add to what we are at all. We never left abidance. So it was suggested that I look at it from this perspective. So there isn't any getting back to anything at all. Of course, this is a practice. Don't try to figure it out with your mind. And it was suggested to me the already practice. If you asked, I asked, well, how do you help somebody who's you know not really tuned in very well to this? And they'd ask questions, and the answer was, you just say to them that I already have the answer. So don't wait for the answer. Practice saying, I already have it, which means right now I have it. Which practicing saying, I've never not had the answer. In fact, I've never needed an answer, actually. Because I'm free. What answer does freedom need? To what question? So this is what Nisargadatta Maharaj is getting at. I'm reading more of his quotes. He's fabulous. I love Maharaj. He says, from the standpoint of absolute beingness is total ignorance. Meaning existence. Meaning, yeah, this. Absolute ignorance, just ignorance, nothing but ignorance. So here we are, July 3rd, 2016, and we are looking at this. There's very little genuine non-dual perspective going on in the world. It's being missed because there's nothing to get. We already have it. We never lost it. So we didn't get pulled out of abidance. It didn't happen. So this takes a determination of will to practice in this way. Because everybody's asking for answers. I got to get enlightenment. No, nobody needs to get enlightenment. Enlightenment is the ignorance, actually. This is one way of looking at it, right? Nobody needs to get enlightenment. We never left reality. We never left our freedom. So why do we need to add something to it? What kind of need could we possibly have? I don't need anything. I don't even need enlightenment. This is the actual non-dual way of practicing. Facebook is just like a beauty show, you know, posing, you know, beautiful pictures and sayings and stuff like that, yeah. But there is a lot of, from these teachers, they give us the non-dual push of that we don't need a push. See, the push that we don't need a push, you know, look at it that way. It's a practice. The practice that we don't need to practice, the push that we don't need to push, the enlightenment that we don't need enlightenment. The real enlightenment is to see that we don't need enlightenment. In fact, we don't need anything. So I remember when I was in abidance, I was aware I was in abidance. And then gradually I felt like I got pulled out of it, got distracted by all this new age stuff that somehow that they're all getting enlightenment. And I said, wow, I need enlightenment. What is enlightenment? And so I thought I had been pulled out of abidance, but in fact, I wasn't at all pulled out of abidance. No one is pulled out of abidance. We can't be pulled out of our own freedom. So we think there's something called enlightenment that we need. So instead of saying, how do I get back? See, here's the key. Instead of saying, how do I get back? The Holy Spirit said, no, no, no. Just insist that you never left. I did not leave abidance. So this is a completely different focus. And this is the shift that very few actually get to this shift. This is the only trouble, is they keep pursuing something. What is there for freedom to pursue? We must stop pursuing. Actually, we're not really pursuing at all. I'm already not pursuing, but we're imagining we're pursuing, but we're really not. What could freedom possibly pursue? So I'm already in abidance. I never left. I never left abidance. So this knocks out all the strategizing of how to get back. It's the strategizing of how to get back, which is the trouble for us. This is the delusion. So it's funny because it's all the positivity that's the delusion. So what we need is super positivity, is to say, I never left. I never left abidance. My attention has been all on all the super positivity. On all this positivity of how do I get back? How do I get back? You know, what do I need to get back? No, there is no getting back because we never left. As soon as we take the position of getting back, then we have to figure out, well, how did we leave? And then we have to deny freedom. We say, well, I must not have been free then. How could we realize what we are when we're denying what we are? With one hand's denying what we are, and the other hand's trying to realize what we are. This is duality. So all the positivity of how do we get back? How do we awaken? I never fell asleep. This is how to practice. I never fell asleep. I've never been asleep at all. How could freedom be asleep? Asleep to what? So this is the real non-dual position, like Srinivasagarada Maharaj has the real non-dual position. of no position. No self, no existence. Just freedom. So there's no getting back. I never left. How did I lose the binds? I didn't lose it. I never lost anything. How can freedom lose something? Can freedom lose something? It's like freedom's picking something up, then setting it down, picking it up, setting it down, picking it up, setting it down, then saying, I keep losing this. What do you mean? It's just a little game. You can pick it up, or you can set it down endlessly. But, or you could not set it down, or you could not pick it up. The freedom is still there. There's nobody that needs to be enlightened. Now, freedom is just like picking it up, setting it down, picking it up, setting it down, picking it up, setting it down, ceaselessly like that. And trying to generate this notion that, well, how do I stop this? Or what's wrong? I keep losing it. I keep losing it. How can I get it? How can I get it? There's nothing to get. There's nothing to get. Again, say this. There's nothing to get. Now this is you have to use your will. We have to use our will to say this. There's nothing to get. We had a fiasco here yesterday. The elders who are starting to have memory issues and all sorts of, you know, keeping details clear, and they were in charge in passing along communication. So my cousin, the mother of my cousin, who was on the phone with the people at the hospital, reported to us that my cousin had died. Clear, plain and simple. She passed away, even gave him the time that she passed away and everything. Well, I was like, I said, that's weird. So they pulled her off life support, but what she was breathing on her own, what kind of life support could she be pulled off of? I was thinking, that's kind of odd. I said, what, IV? Okay, she pulled off IV. But so I said they must have given her, you know, a lethal dose of drugs. I said, but how is that possible in Salt Lake City? I just felt odd about it, you know, and it bothered me. So I finally went in and said, is it possible that the mother made a mistake and she's not dead? And the response I got back, are you crazy? You know, of course not. Are you, that's just the most ridiculous thing ever. But I said, yeah, I know. But it just feels like a dream. It doesn't feel like she's dead, you know. I was feeling so something isn't right. Well, finally, we called back. And the old ladies talked again, and it turns out that she was just taken off quote-unquote life support, which is IV, but she's still alive. So the mother, apparently the mother, said she was dead. And, you know, who's going to challenge the mother on something like this? Well, this is very profound, because I've always said the quote-unquote the mother aspect of the world is mistaken. Okay. We've never been born. Nothing's ever been born, but they insist that we died to what we ourself is dead. You know, the freedom is dead. Mothers say, no, I gave birth to you, so your spiritual perspective is not true anymore. I know that. I said, no, that's not true. So here we have a mother saying that her daughter is definitely dead and passing out this information to everybody, when in fact she's alive. And I just like. So my intuition was right. I kept pushing it. I said, I feel like someone made a mistake here. Is it possible? And I kept pushing it until finally it came out. And then I said, well, okay, so she's off IV, but she's breathing, her organs are okay. That means she can wake up. And they'd put her back on IV if she woke up. So she could come back to life, so to speak. So I summoned all my will and determination. I just said, wake up, wake up, wake up. And I was just the most intense focus, like my life, just a laser beam. You know, I just said, hey, you know, you got to wake up now. You got to wake up because they took you off the IV. I think pretty after just a week, they take you off IV and then let you go. I don't know. I would wait a while, really. That's awfully quick, but anyway, it's just such an amazing situation. It's the mothers and the aunt, you know, the communicate, and who knows who miscommunicated. I just felt there was some error had been made. You know, I said something doesn't feel right to me, and of course I had texted everybody and told everybody that she was dead. You know, so it makes me look bad, right? So if you trust in the matriarch, there's the matriarchs that were delivering this message. They completely bungled the message 100%. I mean, you can't get any more mistake than someone who's alive saying that they're dead. And the matriarchs, that's exactly what they did. And they passed on this message to me, so I'm supposed to pass it out. But I passed it along, but I caught it. You know, it was my spiritual intuition. The Holy Spirit caught it for me and kept saying, hey, I don't think she's dead. She's not dead. You know, I said, but how's that possible, Holy Spirit? No, Holy Spirit, no, she's not dead. I said, well, it's not, what do you mean? So finally, I had to question the mother. I said, maybe she made a mistake and told you, heard improperly, or, you know, bungled the communication, you know, somehow. Is that possible? And yes, that's exactly what happened. They bungled the communication entirely. Isn't that amazing? So let everybody say, hey, cousin, wake up. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. You're not dead. You're not dead. So what we say for us to wake up is say, we never died. We never died. The belief is that when you have a body, you've died to spirit. And the mothers all tell us this. They all do. Every mother in the world, every aunt, every grandmother, everybody here, they all tell us, well, I know I gave birth to you, so I know that this is your life now. So if this is our life, body, we must have died. Spirit must be dead. But I always question this. I said, what? I said, but I don't feel like a body. I feel like spirit. I don't feel dead this way. But they said, no, you're dead. So I tried to be dead because the matriarch, he was telling me that they're all sure of it, you know. But we're not dead. They're mistaken. They're totally mistaken. Totally mistaken. Nothing's ever been born. What? How could anything be born in freedom? Freedom's always free. As Longchenpa said, Buddha and sentient beings are the same in intrinsic spaciousness. Nothing has changed with intrinsic spaciousness at all. But the mothers insist here that it has. This is my experience here. And I see everyone is in the same boat. And so who dares challenge the matriarchy? Well, I do. Nisargadatta Maharaj does. Ramana does, for instance. Yeah. And so I didn't dig into it. Who made the mistake? Blah. It doesn't matter. A severe mistake was made. You know, very severe. So I had to text people back and tell them. And, you know, that was pretty tough. But I was able to do it. I just said, wow, that's a super senior moment, isn't it? But this whole world is just having a super senior moment. The idea that there's such a thing as existence is a super senior moment, we might say. There's no such thing as existence. But they say, no, I'm sure there is. I gave birth to it. No, nothing has been born. No one gave birth to anything, to existence. We're still just perfect freedom. There's never been a self and an existence for a self. We didn't give birth to a self. Nobody's given birth to a self. A body is not a self. It's just a convenient excuse we're making to pretend there's a self. So we project upon the body. It's just an excuse we're using. It's like The matriarch could say, well, we gave you this great excuse, so why don't you use it? Well, we're working really hard to give you an excuse so that you can believe that you're dead. Well, I mean, why would I want to use an excuse to believe I'm dead? That seems like a very arrogant, it's an excuse for arrogance is what it is. So someone's worked really hard to produce an excuse for arrogance, and so we're supposed to accept it? Maybe they're just working hard at their arrogance. And that's their mistake. Why should it be ours? And it goes deeper than that. It's spirit. It's the spirit saying, I worked really hard to produce this, to come up with this excuse. So don't use the excuse. And the spirit says, no, you got to use the excuse. So here is the trouble. The spirit says, you got to use it. I've worked at this so much. I'll be totally flustered if I realize that this has just been an excuse. Well, we don't need to dig it. See, I didn't dig into it. I could tell that the people involved with this were very flustered. To make a mistake of that magnitude, obviously, I wasn't going to get to the bottom of it. Who miscommunicated? Nobody's going to admit to it, right? Ultimately, they'll probably try to say it was me, you know? Of course they will. Of course, and this is what I've gotten in this world. No. Said, no. You miscommunicated. We gave you accuracy, and somehow you misunderstood what we said, even though I was the one who was constantly bugging and say, hey, I don't think this is right. Are you sure? She's dead. Dead? Are you sure? Are you sure? I just got a feeling that something isn't right. I was the one pushing. But the world is ultimately will get it so that, oh yeah, they communicated everything accurately, but I was the one that misunderstood and miscommunicated. This is the lie of the world, right? This is what you get here. You get total lies, miscommunications, and then it claims to know you were the one who bungled it. So what we have to do is say, at this point, we're not going to dig into who bungled it. It was just bungled. And therefore, and so no one lost their freedom. But for sure, the world will try to pin the blame on the one who brings the truth to light. Because they cannot admit that they made the mistake. Our spirit doesn't want to admit that it's made a mistake. Unrepentant spirit doesn't want to admit that it's made a mistake. It said, no, we got it right. But you got it wrong, so... And then it says, since you got it wrong, what you're saying now must, we can't trust in what you're saying now, that we didn't make a mistake. And you see, it goes, then it just gets in this churning confusion, and they just go into confusion. So, we have to trust in the ones who are telling us the truth, that, you know, that's repentant spirit. Repentant spirit is not mistaken. Otherwise, you just have this impossible confusion going on. Impossible confusion, right? And so I feel there's this effort of will. We have to gather our will, which we're doing here. Now in the past I would have been very upset and tried to get to the bottom of this, but I just dropped it. I said it's no time for this. The unrepentant mind cannot awaken because it refuses to take responsibility as spirit for this mistake. Spirit says, I couldn't possibly have made the mistake. Something else must have made this mistake. So it's saying there must be something else other than spirit that made this mistake. And this is where the devil comes in, you know, Lucifer, the devil, all this. It is because we can't admit that we made this error, mistake. But it was really just whimsicality. It was kind of saying, let's see if I can make a mistake. Well, ultimately, we can't, can we? We can't really make any mistake at all because we never lost our freedom. So where's the mistake? Where's the evidence? There's no evidence. So you could even say, I thought I made a mistake, but I didn't. This is the whopper. I thought I was deluded, but I wasn't. So you see how this puts us in a different focus, doesn't it? It changes our focus. And we need to be determined and quiet. In order to have this changed focus, we can't go back to the old one, can we? I thought I made a mistake, but I really didn't. I never made a mistake. I whimsically tried to believe that I had made a mistake, but I really didn't. No one's made a mistake at all. Try that focus. So here, we were working on this, shifting to this other focus here. And it's difficult. Because the ordinary support system isn't there anymore. And so it's just an effort of will and determination. We need to be desperately determined to get to this other focus. Desperately determined. But if we are, we can get to it. I've gotten to it before. This other focus that I never made a mistake. No one's ever made a mistake. We're incapable of making a mistake. How could freedom make a mistake? So, it's what we need is the gathering of this will and determination to shift our focus like this. This is what we all have so much trouble with in the world. This is called the path. It is just gathering this, the will to make this shift in focus. That's all that it is. So that part is difficult, yes. And this is what the Holy Spirit helps us out with. And we think, I can never gather the will to admit that I never made a mistake. I didn't make a mistake in the first place. I've been trying to correct my mistake for so long, and the truth is I never made a mistake. No one has. What a whopper that is. Now, is that a mistake? No. I haven't made any mistakes at all. Even trying to correct a mistake is not a mistake. I'm incapable of making any mistakes. Now, when we try to look at it like this, how do you feel? How do you feel? Is it not a wow reaction? Just stick with the wow reaction. Don't allow yourself to go anywhere other than that. When you try to react, if you do react, at some point you may start feeling like, I need to react. Just stick with the wow reaction. Refuse to go back to the old focus. And just say, I never fell asleep. What do you mean wake up? I never fell asleep. Try this focus. This is the real practice. This is what we're, this is what has to be done. You'd have to say this pragmatically. I never fell asleep. I don't need to wake up because I never fell asleep. This is our focus. And I can feel this just, wow, like I'm shifting focus and leaving the other focus behind. And this is like this feeling like, so don't look in the rearview mirror, okay? Don't look in the rearview mirror. This is another way, full stop in the wow. Just refuse to look in the rearview mirror. Because there's nothing to see there, actually. Just tell yourself, there's nothing to see in the rearview mirror at all. I don't need to wake up. I never fell asleep. So there's nothing in the rearview mirror at all. Refuse to look. As soon as we look in the rearview mirror, we immediately believe that there's something to see there. Because we're too afraid to look at it and see there's nothing to see there. So don't take that effort to look in the rearview mirror. Just full stop in the wow here. So it's easy to tell if your path is if the Holy Spirit's, well, it's easy to tell how you're doing is if you can practice like this, just for even a little bit. This means you're certainly a non-dualist. Certainly, your will is being gathered. And so you just do it. It's like you're compelled, full stop, in the wild. Don't look in the rearview mirror. There's nothing to see there. I never made a mistake. I never fell asleep. I never made a mistake. Stay with the positive side of it. Instead of saying, I don't need to wake up, say, well, I mean, instead of saying, I never fell asleep. I never fell asleep. Instead of trying to work on, okay, well, how do I then not wake up? Don't do that. That's looking in the rearview mirror. In other words, stay with the positive, super positive, rather. Don't go back to the positive. Stay with the super positive. Don't go back to the positive. Stay with the super positive. So, I never fell asleep. No one's ever fallen asleep. It's impossible for me to fall asleep. I have no need to wake up. I never fell asleep. I never made a mistake. So instead of saying, well, how? No, how? I never made a mistake. So the super positive never says how. It doesn't say how. It says, I'm incapable of making any mistake. It's impossible. I've never made a mistake. I did not make a mistake. We never say, well, how did I not make a mistake? Don't put the how in there. Say, I never made a mistake. This is practicing. Refuse to allow the other focus to try and come into the picture. Now, this is Nisargadatta Maharaj. Look at him. He was just intent, and he refused to let the other perspective come in. Ram Maharshi, they refused to let that other perspective drift in. And of course, everyone that comes to him is trying to, you know, get that other perspective to drift in. But how can I be enlightened, Maharaj? What do you mean? I don't need to be enlightened. I feel so terrible. No, I've never felt terrible. I've never made a mistake. I never fell asleep. I never made any mistake whatsoever. Ram Maharshi uses the analogy of someone who's on a train, and they have all this luggage on the train, and they're still carrying their luggage. They're walking around, you know, carrying their luggage and on the train. I said, well, I've got to, you know, get the luggage. I got to take it to where I'm going. I said, well, the train is taking you where you're going. He said, set the luggage down on the, but they won't. They won't set the luggage down. So we're all like that. We're all like holding our luggage. And we're not setting it down. But we're going even further. We never had any luggage. We've never had any luggage. So, the key is to shift from positivity to super positivity. This, and you can tell this is quite a shift, because one is the rear, looking in the rearview mirror, imagining, and the other is right here, right now. I never left now. I never fell asleep. I've never been deluded. Says I've never been deluded at all. Okay, this is how to practice. I've never been deluded at all. So. We just keep introducing this, gathering our will to do this. We say, well, how do I gather my will? I never lost my will. But pragmatically, well, the Holy Spirit is gathering our will. Everything in our life is helping us gather our will. To practice in this super positive way. Super positive affirmation. Not only am I already there, I never left. I never left. No one has ever left. There's no such thing as leaving. Leaving is impossible. No one has fallen asleep. No one is deluded. No one made any mistake. Nothing has ever happened. Now, we're not just saying this for effect. We're actually affirming this as our focus. This is what we believe in. Okay, this is what we believe in. I absolutely believe this when I'm saying it. This is true. So we are saying this because it is true. And we are allowing ourselves to remain in this focus as this is the truth and this is where I am. I've never been anywhere else. I've never been anywhere other than in truth. I've never been anywhere else other than in truth. There's nowhere else to be. I've never been anywhere else. We could say, no one has ever suffered. No one has ever suffered at all. There's never been any suffering take place. Suffering has never taken place. There's only been bliss. Always. Everything is already bliss. It's always been bliss. There's nothing other than bliss. No suffering has ever taken place. So we're at the point now where we're just practicing, summoning the will to practice like this. Now it helps to have these great these Dharma kings are helping out. So they're helping me summon my will right now. So no one has ever gone crazy. No one has ever gone crazy. I've never been crazy. No one has ever been crazy. No one has ever been sick. No one has ever suffered. No one has ever died. This never happened. Never happened. When people then ask, well, how do I get there? You have bliss. How do I get bliss? You say, you already have it. You've always had bliss. I've always only experienced bliss. There's nothing else to experience. I'm already blissful. I've always been blissful. I've never been sad. And they say, what are you talking about? How do I get there? But no, there's no getting there. I never left. So what they're trying to do is they're trying to understand what you're saying instead of practicing it. So what all the teachers tell us is you have to practice this. You have to assert it instead of trying to understand it. There's nothing to understand. There's nothing to understand. How could there be? What does freedom need to understand? There's never been anything to understand. There's never been anything to understand. Now, we tell ourselves the lie that the body will reject all this and die, you know, if we say this. That's not true. Just don't try to make the body die. If we project death upon the body, of course, it will appear to be dead. But just don't blame the body at all. Leave the body out of this. Okay? Leave the body out of this entirely. In fact, we could say there's never been a body. The matriarchy doesn't like this, but it's true, there's never been a body. Who is the body that claims that it's making bodies? That body also has never existed. There isn't any matriarchy. Nothing's ever been born. There's no claim at all to this. This is all mental projection. It's all mental projection. And again, this is a focus. We're practicing this focus. We're not trying to say how to get to this focus. We're practicing the focus. See, this is the difference, right? We're practicing this focus. It's a focus that we're practicing. We're not struggling to get to this focus. We already have it. We're just practicing it. So the will to practice in this way is what is key. It's just a direct will. There's no understanding to it. It's a direct will that comes from your spirit. It's a direct will. And then the question is, well, how do I get this will? This is, you have to have faith. You have to have faith, and you have to trust it. And say, I've always had the will. I've always had the will. I've never not had the will. I've always had the will. I've always had the will to practice like this. Say this, I've always had the will to practice like this. So when we're practicing, we're not looking in the rearview mirror, well, how did I get the will? See, this is how we dissipate it. So this is why we just say, trust it. You know, there's a super powerful mantra we have, which is trust it. I've always had the will. So you say, well, how did I get what I've always had? Immediately, we lose the focus, just like that, immediately. I've always had the will. It's just that we were insisting that's taboo to say this, to you know. No, you can't do that. You have to honor death, not having the will. Well, I've always had the will. So how can I honor not having what I've always had it? This is absurd. So really, we either just foment absurdity, or we recognize truth. Or we practice. I've always recognized truth. I've always been aware of truth. Say this, I've always been aware of truth. I never lost focus on truth. I'd never lost focus on truth. So we're practicing in a super positive way here. It's July 2016. It's time for that. And right on cue, you know, here we go. Holy Spirit's God is going up and running. I never lost sight of truth. Not even for a moment have I ever lost sight of truth. I've never been deluded. Not even for an instant have I ever been deluded. Never for even an instant has anyone ever been deluded. No one's ever been deluded. So practicing in this way is the most taboo there is. And so we say, I've never suffered from any taboo. There is no taboo. No one's ever been deluded. No one's ever been restricted. No one's ever fallen asleep. No one has ever suffered. None of us have ever suffered at all. This is all just, you know, utter fantasy. Nothing in this fantasy, just, you know, nothing to this fantasy at all in terms of the struggle and everything. It never happened. And so I never fell asleep. I never dreamed. No one has ever dreamed, even for a moment, actually. Because the truth is, we're projecting this whole thing moment by moment. See, we keep thinking there's time. There's no such thing as time. So the super positivity is shifting our focus away from the belief in time, right? To asserting the truth. There's no continuity to the fantasy at all. So it never happened. The whole idea of a fantasy is that there's continuity to it. There isn't any. So it never happened. A happening implies time. Time never happened. Time has never happened to anyone. No one's ever experienced time. No one has ever experienced time. Doesn't exist. Never. Existence doesn't exist. Time doesn't exist, meaning existence has never been. There's never been existence. This bird is digging, looking for seeds, you know. It hops around and scratches its feet and tries to uncover stuff. There's nothing to uncover. There's absolutely nothing to uncover. I've never uncovered anything. There's nothing to uncover. I've never uncovered anything. There's nothing to uncover. Now, the trouble's always been, we've had trouble practicing this way. So what we say is, I've never had any trouble at all. I've never had any trouble at all. So the way to practice is, whatever arises for you, put it into a super positive context, right? Just put it right in directly. There's nothing else to do. Super positive is directly. It's now. I've never had any trouble. I've never had any trouble experiencing the now. I've never had the slightest bit of trouble. No one's ever had the slightest bit of trouble. Has any of us ever been troubled by time? Well, how could we be troubled with what has never existed? So, it's impossible. So I've never had any trouble. We're all just kind of waiting for the impossible to trouble us. But none of us have ever been troubled, actually. I've never been troubled in the slightest bit. I've never experienced any trouble at all. I've never experienced any trouble at all. Now, everybody would like to practice in this way, but the pressure on them is that they feel people say, oh, you're crazy, and so they just, you know, limp along. But we say, I've never limped along. I've never experienced even a tiniest bit of trouble. So keep shifting from the pragmatic to the practicing, from pragmatic to practicing. Because ultimately practicing is the pragmatic, isn't it? I've never had any trouble practicing. I've never experienced even the slightest bit of trouble practicing. And people say, what about all the times that you had? I never had any time. I've never experienced time. I've never experienced trouble at all. Trust it. I've never not trusted it. Practice that. I've never not trusted it. So we go from positive to super positive. And the only way to go to super positive is through practicing it. It cannot be theory. You cannot get it from the standpoint of theoretical or thinking about it. You just have to actually practice it. The super positive can only be practiced. As soon as you're thinking about it, you're not being super positive anymore. There's nothing to think about. I am it. I've always been it. There's nothing to think about at all. Absolutely nothing to think about. There's never been anything at all to think about. There's never been anything at all to think about. So I've never thought at all. I've never had any thoughts. Okay, I've never had any thoughts. None. I've never had even the Not even one thought. I've never had even one thought. I've never had any thoughts whatsoever. No one has ever had any thoughts. There's never been even a single thought ever take place. It's never taken place. So just wow, wow this, just wow. I mean, to stay engaged with your practicing. We've believed in thought, but we've never had a thought. Okay? We've believed. We've desired a thought. But we've never had a thought. There are no thoughts. Everything that we believe we've been experiencing and struggling, suffering, it's only a desire to experience it. We've never actually experienced it. There's nothing there to experience. We've never experienced a thought. We've never experienced suffering. We've never experienced death. We've never experienced thinking. I've never thought. I've never been thinking at all. I've had a desire to experience it, but I've never experienced it because it's not there to experience. There's no such thing as time. We can't experience time. It doesn't exist. We cannot experience existence. It doesn't exist. It can never exist. Existence can never exist. I mean, time can never, there's no such thing as time. It can never be. There's only the freedom, which is always now. So, I've never been trapped. So the question, the positivist will say, well, how do I stop thinking? The super positivist will say, I've never started thinking. No one's ever started thinking. There's never been any starting of thinking at all. There's never been any thinking ever take place. Thinking has never taken place for any of us. I've never had any need for realization. No one has. No one has any need for realization at all. Never have. We never fell asleep. We've never not been realized. We've never not been realized. So, as we do super positive practice, you see that we sit very kind of still like this. We're just kind of feeling is like, wow, I don't even want to move here. This is very intense. It's not that difficult to practice way. In fact, it's not difficult at all. I've never had any difficulty. I've never experienced difficulty at all. Not even the tiniest bit. Practice like that. Pragmatically, we feel this wow reaction. But it's just because we think, well, nobody else is doing this, so it must be difficult. We assume this. No, there's no difficulty to it, which is why nobody's doing it, because they're trying to do what is difficult. They're trying to generate difficulty. So nobody's doing what has no difficulty to it, because they're believing in difficulty. But there is no difficulty. It doesn't exist. So the bridge is this practice of saying there's no difficulty, there's no bridge. The bridge is to assert there's no bridge at all. You've always been there. There's nowhere to get to. This is the bridge. So the bridge is to assert there is no bridge. Okay, this is called superpositivity. Just look at it that way. Now, bridge is to assert there is no bridge. There is no bridge. There's never been a bridge. There's no need for a bridge at all. How could there be a bridge to freedom? From where? There is no bridge. But you see, you can never get this from a theoretical thinking standpoint. You can only get it from a practice standpoint. So this is what I've been generating in the videos, is to keep us generating the will to practice like this. The remedy is to assert there is no remedy. Nothing needs to be remedied. The bridge is to assert that there is no bridge. That is, the remedy is to assert there's no need for any remedy. And this is done by way of practice, believing in it, trusting in it. It's just simple, trust it. So these gurus develop this trust in us. They generate, well, they bring it out in us, so to speak, and trust it. So this is the only pragmatic, if you want to say there's anything at all, which there isn't, but not even trust, but from a pragmatic standpoint, we'll say, if you want to have some focus, some spark plug, it just trust it. How do you spark this practice? Trust it. That's how you spark it. And these teachers, these Dharma kings, have been getting through to me, and you know, trust it. Nisargadatta Maharaj doing a great job. Just like, it's Facebook page is Hammers, HAMMERS, I think, Hammers of Nisargadatta Maharaj. Nisargadatta Maharaj. Hammers of Nisargadatta Maharaj. And it's very helpful, along with Ramana and Sri Sri Anandamayama and the rest. They each bring their own kind of flavor of helpfulness, and to, for what? That the bridge is to realize there is no bridge. There's never been a bridge. I don't need any bridge. The help is to realize there is no help. I've never needed the slightest bit of help. There is no help at all. How could there be help? For what? So the help is to practice saying, there is no help. There's no such thing as help. Help doesn't exist. The hope is to practicing. There's no such thing as hope. There's no hope whatsoever. Hope doesn't exist. What could possibly need hope? There's no need for hope. There's no hope. There's no help. There's no bridge. But this is practicing. So the help is to practice saying, I don't need help. There is no help. The help is to practice saying, there is no help. No help exists at all. Never has. See, that ends the search. Searching for help. There is no search for anything whatsoever. I've never searched at all. I have never searched at all. I've never searched at all. There is no shift. I've never shifted. There is no shift to make. I've never made any shift. I have no need to make any shift at all. So the shift is to practice saying, there is no shift. The bridge is to practice saying, there is no bridge. The bridge is to practice saying, there is no bridge. So who is inspiring this? Longchenpa, Jesus, Ramaharshi, Nanamayama, Longchenpa, Jamyang Choki Lodro, Nisargadatta Maharaj. They're the ones who are inspiring this. And the inspiration is to say, there is no inspiration. There is no inspiration whatsoever. I've never experienced inspiration. So, everything other than bliss, was, I've never experienced it. There, it doesn't exist. It's never existed. The bridge is to realize there's never been a bridge. The inspiration is to realize there's never been any inspiration. So, they say, even though we're using words, it's the words are never it. Okay. So, they're not... They're really all only inspiring, calling us to practice. That there's never been a call to practice. Practice. There's never been a call to practice. There's never been a call to practice. Now you might be saying, well, the gurus are, they spend all our effort calling us to practice. And what you're saying, there's never been a call to practice. That's exactly what how they want us to practice. There's never been a call to practice. There's never been any call to practice whatsoever. I've never practiced at all. And if we're in abidance, we experience it. We say, "Well, how did you shift?" I didn't shift. The shift is that there is no shift. The shift is that there is no shift. The shift is that there is no shift. There's never been a shift to make. What kind of shift could perfect freedom need to make? So that we've always been perfect freedom. So there is no shift to make. The shift is that there is no shift to make. Practice like this. The shift is that there is no shift to make. The gathering of the will is that there is no gathering of the will. There's no will to gather. The gathering of the will is that there is no will to gather. The shift is that there is no shift to make. there is no shift to make is the shift. Practice this. Don't think it. Don't understand it. Understanding is that there's nothing to understand. Understanding is that there's nothing to understand. Now, you see, as we accept this in the mind, the body is fine. The body just sits here. Nothing happens to the body. Nothing's ever happened to the body, actually. Nothing can ever happen to the body. There is no body. The shift is that there is no shift. And to practice this, practice the shift is that there is no shift. This is practice. Feel. How does it feel? Body by body feels fine. I feel fine. I feel the wow is all I feel. So all I project upon the body is just the wow. Nothing more than that. Nothing more than that. And the wow is that there is no wow. The shift is that there is no shift. I've never experienced anything at all. Be patient with it. I've never practiced. The practice is that I've never practiced. No one has ever practiced at all. No one has ever practiced whatsoever. My life is that I have no life. My life is that I have no life. My life is that I have no life. Practice that. Believing this. My life is that I have no life. I've never had a life. No one has ever had a life. No one has ever had a life. There's never been a life at all. My life is that there's never been a life. My life is that there's never been a life. My silence is that there's never been anyone being silent. There's nothing being silent. My silence is that there's nothing being silent. My life is that there's never been a life. My silence is that there's never been a silence. My silence is that there's never been any silence. There's never been any silence. Never been any silence. My silence is that there's never been any silence. My life is that there's never been any life. Now we really project fatigue on the body too and say, well, I'm getting tired. You know, I can't practice anymore. I'm getting tired. That too. I've never been tired. No one's ever been tired. Beautiful California day. Cool. As far as summer goes, it's very mild now with breeze. Soft breeze. And so we think, well, this must be tiring me out. I've never been tired out. I've never been tired out. I've never experienced even a speck of fatigue. I've never been tired out. Practice in this way. So you can see that the lack of this way of practicing in the world is you might ask yourself, a question just may arise, like, why? You know, why? Because there's a lack of this type of way of practicing taking place. We're always trying to get to it. You never get to it. The getting to it is to realize you never get to it. The getting to it is to realize you never get to it. I'm gonna make some picture. I'm gonna make some graphics on Facebook and put these practices on there. Okay, I mean, the getting to it is that you never get to it. I'll put my name to it, you know, all the quotes, you know, Ram Maharshi, Longchenpa and such. Yeah, well, you know, these are my, you know, sayings. I mean, I'm saying it here. Yeah. So I'll have to say that. Why not? Because this is where the focus needs to be. This is where the practicing has to be there. Otherwise, you know, there is no getting to it. The getting to it is that there is no getting to it. The getting to it is that there is no getting to it. In other words, we have to use the will to just start the practice. There's no getting to the practice. No getting to the practice is the getting to it. No getting to the practice is the getting to it. So you just, the will, you to trust it. The will to trust it. It just starts. That's all. There's no getting to it. No getting to it is the getting to it. It's not that it's difficult. It's just that no one does it. So we assume it must be difficult. We say, oh, yeah, okay, there's an excuse. It's difficult. That's why we're not doing it. No. We're not doing it because we're choosing to be arrogant. That's all. We're not practicing in a super positive way just because we're arrogant. Still choosing to be arrogant. We're not repenting. Not getting there is getting there. 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 Trust it. We're told if we practice this way, we'll immediately die. This is what the matriarchy and the ego tells us, and the belief that we've been born, that if we say we've never been born, then we'll die. But how can we die if we've never been born? It's ridiculous, isn't it? And so we're afraid that we'll die. But it's ridiculous. My body's still functioning fine. I could sing an aria right now if I warmed my voice up. Or maybe at least a Beach Boy song. If I have a good voice there, I don't know. So, never know. It's weird. You wake up, your voice. You can tell how you change. It's interesting how your voice is. Every day it's different. And from moment to moment, your voice is different. So we're intimidated and bullied and told. We tell ourselves this, that we'll die. We say, I've never been bullied. I've never been bullied for even for an instant. So take whatever fear we have and insist it's never happened. I've been bullied into this. No, I've never been bullied. I've never experienced bullying. No one ever has. No one's ever been bullied. So the authority to practice, I assure you, the authority's there. And so I'm echoing the authority that I've gotten. I know there are those who practice in a positive way that would say, no, that's just ridiculous, you know, stuff happens, people have accidents. No, there's never been any accident. No one's ever had an accident. No one's ever experienced an accident. Therefore, no accident has ever taken place. This is absolutely true. So we have to practice in this way. So it's not something theoretical that we're practicing. We're asserting and believing. trusting it. I mean, I have great trust in what I'm saying is true. Absolutely, I do. I know this is so because of continuity fear. I need to practice it. Only because of continuity fear, I need to practice it. But I know it's true, so I trust it. And these Dharma kings help me trust it. They help us trust it. So anyone who helps you trust this, that's where you put your attention and focus right now. It's not on the positivists anymore, okay? They've helped, to a certain extent, start gathering our will. Everything can play a role in gathering our will, actually. The Holy Spirit orchestrates it. So we don't need to worry about that. But between the positivists and the super positivists, there's no getting there. There's no getting from one to the other. You're either one or the other. There's no getting to it. The no getting to it is it. The no getting to it is it. The no getting to it is it. So, you can feel the influence of like Lanchenpa and Jesus Christ and Sri Srinadmaya, the Sagarada Maharaj, Ramana Maharshi. And you could feel the influence of them here. You can feel that influence. And there's an absence of the influence of the positivists. This is not putting them down at all, but there's an absence of that influence here. How do we honor both? Well, not honoring both is the honoring of both. Not honoring both is the honoring of both. There's never been anything to honor, actually, at all. Not honoring is the honoring. Not honoring is the honoring. Many may say, well, I can't say this. I said, what do you mean you can't say this? I mean, you got a college degree, right? Oh, yeah, of course, I'm a professional. Well, so you can use words? Oh, yeah, of course I can use words. But you can't say not honoring is the honoring. Not getting there is the getting there. You can't say that? Why, you can't pronounce the words? No, I can't say that. So then all this talk and education you got is just a compensation. Huh? For not being able to say this? Or as an excuse? Say, well, I'm saying all this other stuff, I don't have to say this. So is it a question of not being able to say it or not being willing to say it? Not being willing to say it is what? Arrogance. Nothing other than that. Don't ever think there's anything other than that in terms of our resistance. It's 100% arrogance. Nothing other than that. It's never anything other than arrogance. And we just have to ask ourselves, do I want to continue being arrogant? That's all. That's the only question we need to ask ourselves. There's no academic structure to it at all. It's just, do I want to continue being arrogant? That's all. Yes or no? If it's yes, it's yes. If it's no, it's no. That's the end of it. And the next moment, ask yourself the same question. There's no academic structure to the situation whatsoever. There's never been any structure, and there's never been any situation. Just truth or arrogance, which is really just a desire to deny truth. So it's just arrogance. So do I want to keep being arrogant or not? That's the only question there is. And of course, to say then, I've never been arrogant, is to stop being arrogant, right? I mean, right? You have to practice that. I've never been arrogant. The belief that arrogance is possible is the arrogance. So say, I've never been arrogant. No one has ever been arrogant at all. And relax, stay relaxed. Don't tighten up. I started tightening up there and shuddering. I said, I don't need to shudder. Why? The body's innocent of anything at all, so it's just neutral. It's nothing at all, so I don't need to tighten up. I've never been arrogant. No one has ever been arrogant, even in the slightest bit. Practice this. And just relax, relax. Stay relaxed. So we're proving to ourselves that we can practice in this way. This is what is so powerful. The power is in the proof. It's in the doing of it. The power is in the doing of it. It's not in the understanding of it. It's in the doing of it. Just stay relaxed with the body. Don't try to relax. Just don't try to tense up. There's no need to project difficulty upon the body. Just say, no, there's no difficulty. I've never experienced any difficulty. There's no difficulty. Just remind yourself that, oh, and then you just feel less, you know, less tightened up, so to speak. Don't project it. There's no difficulty in this at all, what we're doing. I've never experienced any difficulty. No one has. So just wow it. Just wow. Just let the wow reaction be with the body. The body's just in a sort of a wow reaction as well. It's not tension. Just wow. Doesn't know what to think. We don't know what to think. Wow. Don't accept it. Don't reject it. Don't say, I know what to think and accept. In other words, I know what to think and accepting it. I know what to think and reject it. Don't think. Don't accept it or reject it. Full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. The Holy Spirit is suggesting something to me this morning. It's suggesting something to me. I say, like, huh? Okay. Okay, we'll see what we can do. Pragmatically. You're still the pragmatic level, but this is just a way of bringing our focus back to this super positive practicing. That's all that it is. That's all that it is. So full stop in the wow, full stop in the wow. So you feel fine. So we've gone past the wall of our expectations here by practicing in a super positive way. So we've just gone past the wall of our expectations. When I say the world is going to be capped, and we're going to do a little cool down period here now, okay? So this is a cool down period. We've done our intense affirmations. We've just wowed it all, and now we're going to do a little cool down. Okay, a little cool down, a little flipping the script, a little cool down. We've gone past our expectations, and now we're going to gather our will for another push a little later in the day, or maybe tomorrow or whatever. But we'll keep, now we'll work to gather our will again to push past even the expectations that arise from this practice we had here. So we're just staying in the flow of our overall practicing like this, right? Assertions, full stop in the wow, flipping the script. Assertions, full stop in the mouth, flipping the script. Flipping the script is gathering our will. We gather our will to practice assertions once again. Like that. It's easy, right? Very simple. So we just realize, okay, that this is what we've done. We've done a great job. We pushed through the wall of our expectations. Now, the world is going to cap our expectations, try to cap it with just positivism. Okay, positivism is going to cap it. And obviously, this brings about despair. So this is the concern that we have, which is why we have to really push past, keep practicing pushing past expectations, not cap them. Don't try to cap it. Keep trying to push past it. So don't fixate even on your success or anything. Just stay in the wow. And say, I've never been successful. No one's ever been successful at all. That's back to assertions. So the trouble is coming is that there's this overall capping where we decide, okay, we're good. We have a new world order. We have a new millennium coming. Okay, so we can learn to be happy. We can learn to be spiritual. We can learn to have a peaceful, compassionate world. We can do this. This is all positivism. Okay, and positivism is how we cap our expectations. So this has nothing to do with non-dual, you know, quote-unquote, non-dual, non-realization. Non-dual, non-realization. That I've never not been realized. There's nothing to realize. So it has nothing to do with actual, what we really want. Let's put it this way. It has nothing to do with what we really want at all. And so it certainly will bring up a great despair, which we then have to cover up and suffocate somehow. So you might say that the world is going to go into this extreme suffocation mode. And this is what I experienced when I was in Palo Alto, and the POTUS, President of the United States, was passing by in a motorcade about a mile away from where I was. He was in the area close by, and I was working in Palo Alto. And I suddenly experienced a suffocation, a coughing. And I tried to talk, and I started coughing again, and tried to cough. Coughing again, and it went on and on and on. I couldn't stop the coughing. It was terrible. It was interference with my self-expression, like a suffocation. And so the POTUS, of course, is someone who's the figurehead of this effort that those here in the world, that quote unquote in the world, are trying to produce, is this new world order, a new world, a new millennium of peace and happiness and all this. This is positivism, and so he's a figurehead for those who are trying to cap our expectations at positivism, and this produces like a suffocation in us, because this is a despair which we then try to suffocate. Produces this terrible despair, and we don't know why. I don't know why I feel this way. And then we immediately try to suffocate it. So all the agents of suffocation are in the world now, ready to suffocate us with positivism. But keep in mind that Longchenpa is in the house, okay? Keep in mind that Longchenpa is in the house. Jesus is in the house. Sri Sri Anandamayi is in the house. Ram Maharshi is in the house. Nisargadatta Maharaj is in the house. Jamyang Genzi Choki Lodro is in the house. Keep in mind. And on Nyingma Masters, a Thangka of Longchenpa came up, and a quote from Longchenpa. Of course, they gave a positive quote. They tried to give a positive quote. The quote was a way, it was trying to present Longchenpa as a positivist, actually. But I comment, I said, there's nothing that makes me feel better than Longchenpa being in the house. You know, Longchenpa is in the house. I just get this feeling of assurance. I get this super positive feeling. As soon as the name Longchenpa comes up, I get this very, very super positive feeling. It's just like a miracle. You know, just the very thought of turning my attention to the name of Longchenpa. Wow, do I get a sense of assurance that we're world beaters here. You know, we're going to beat positivity. Absolutely. And this is a great, 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 great boost for us to have this kind of reaction here to a Dharma King, this super positive reaction. The mere mention of his name is enough to produce this in me. Suddenly, I feel super positive, just like that. See, with Longchenpa, you can't really be positive with him, which is why he doesn't have a boost on Facebook. There's certain teachers who are not boosted. Jesus is not boosted, and Longchenpa is not boosted. Because they're so powerful in evoking in this super positive feeling. Just boom. Now, they've worked so hard to suffocate Jesus that I can get the super positive feeling, but it's more difficult. But with Longchenpa, they haven't really the apparatus has not yet focused on suffocating him so much. Not so much. Not as much as Jesus. They've really gone all out to suffocate Jesus. Okay, and I find that I post a lot of different posts on Facebook. Graphics with quotes, and I blend it all, and there's a lot of all these Dharma kings, and there's a lot of Jesus there, and nobody likes or shares at all Jesus. No, he's an orphan. He's been orphaned, and that really is tough to take, I'll tell you, for me. But I'm taking it, you know. I just have to laugh with Jesus. I just say, Jesus. So, but they haven't suffocated Longchenpa so much yet. It's a bit Tibetan Buddhists, maybe to some extent, they're trying to. But as far as globally, the big picture, no, no. Not so much suffocation there. So I can just say the word Longchenpa, and pow! I'm in super positive mode, just like that. He has the capacity to just completely lift us out of positivism, like just instantly. That's the only way to be lifted out, is instantly, actually. The way to super positive is instant. The way is instant. The path is instant. It's an instant path. It's an instant path. The path is an instant path. And so Longchenpa just instantly, I'm there. Just instantly, I'm there. And so people resist that. This is why he hasn't caught on yet. People are not catching on to it. They're not catching on to it. I keep posting, they don't catch on to it. They don't like Longchenpa either. No. They don't. They don't share, and they don't like Jesus or Longchenpa. I've been testing out, you know, the psyche of the world through Facebook, and I'm seeing what's what. They haven't got to Longchenpa yet. He's not suffocated. There's no suffocation factor there. And so, wow. Is he helpful? I'm telling you. He's super helpful. He's instantly helpful. All help is instant help. All help is instant help. So I could run out 1,000 Facebook postings on Jesus Longchenpa. No one would like him or share them. This is true. It just doesn't matter how much you put out. The positivist paradigm views that as obstructionist, because they don't want the path to be instant. They want to get there. There's no getting there. The no getting there is getting there. The instant path is the only path there is. All else is just aimlessly wandering around, as Jesus puts it. The innocent path is the only path there is. All else is just aimless wandering around. Stop in the wow. Don't think, don't try to see how the body, how is the body generating this? It's not, body's not generating anything. The body has never generated anything. Therefore, there is no body. There is no generation body, generating body at all. And yet, trust it, trust it, trust it, trust it. Don't turn to the body for any answers whatsoever. Positivism is body-based. Turns to the body for answers. And of course, it says, well, yeah, but we're doing both, yeah. No, it turns to the body for answers. There is no both. There is no, there's never been both. There isn't any both at all. There's only the one. There's never been both. There's never been both. And now we're back in practice. Yeah, we're trying to cool down here. This is what happens, right? You got to cool down. So the world, the capping is coming. The capping is coming. It's funny, on my Facebook page, there's on the right side where the advertisements are, there's always this advertisement, always, of what? Cap. Cap, isn't the Holy Spirit interesting? And this is short for Colin Kaepernick, quarterback of the 49ers, at least used to be. Always, you know, terrible tragedy in the NFL. You know, these ads are so deceptive. You know, they make it seem like some breaking news and some really terrible thing has happened. It's actually advertisements for products and stuff. Don't click on it. Those Facebook ads are ridiculous. But it's Colin Kaepernick. We call him Cap. So, the news, breaking news, tragedy, what is it? Cap. The capping that's coming. Isn't this amazing, Holy Spirit? The capping that is coming. And this is it, the positivist cap. I'm just sending these super positive assertions to my cousin who's lying in a hospital in Salt Lake City with no one helping her. They're just letting her die. Well, she's letting herself die, actually. No one's letting her die. She's letting herself die. And nothing's dying. But from a communication standpoint, we can still use the body for that. So I still say, wake up. You know, you've got great truth to communicate. Wake up. You have great truth to communicate. What did you experience while you're in this coma? Well, you experienced all this help, all the support, all the super positivity, right? All the super positivity you experienced. So come back and tell the world, this is what I experienced. Maybe some people won't understand you. Well, we will. So wake up, wake up, wake up and communicate it. Wake up and communicate it. Absolutely. It will give us pause to consider, will it not? It will be part of gathering our will. So be part of helping us gather our will, come back from the dead, so to speak. You're letting yourself die. You're letting yourself go into the kingdom of death. Now come back from that. Come back from that. The realm of death. You know, come back from that. This is what I'm sending, you know, to her. This will. We had a dog in the extended family, the extended family dog, the you know, that is ever quote unquote so important, right? Dogs are never important for me at this point. No. They give positivity. It's all dogs, and dogs are enabling, is bringing us to positivity. Okay. Not super positivity. Dogs are not involved in super positivity. So the obsession with dogs is how we are pulling, capping our expectations. That's how they're helping out. This is why it's amazing the obsession that people have with dogs now, because they're obsessed with capping their expectations into just positivity. I think the only way we can have this millennium is that we're all just positive. Now, that's the only way that you can continue on with your, you know, arrogance, actually. That's the only term we really need to use. That's all we're doing, is just continue to be arrogant. Do I want to continue to be arrogant? Oh yeah, we'll have this millennium, so we can continue to be arrogant, is all. So we had this dog, the dog suddenly got ill, very shocking, really. I mean, the dog seemed perfectly healthy one day, and then I hear that it's sick, and before you know it, they put it to sleep. It had some blood cancer or something. And you know, it's like, I went over and talked to the dog. It still looked fine, but it couldn't move. But its eyes looked at me, and its ears could hear me, and it was, you know, it was very appreciative. I came over and said, "Hey, you know, okay." So we've had this, and then our cousin, just suddenly, you know, just going to the store. Boom. Now she can't move. So these are things that help cap our expectations in the positive. So I'm saying, you don't have to do that. Not for my sake, you don't. Not for my sake. Not for my sake. You can come back and communicate the realization now that, wow, there is no death. None of this is true. You can be a force to help us move past the capping, right? Absolutely. I absolutely welcome that. And there are others that will welcome it. That's what I'm saying. These are my prayers. Just give a reason to come back. I'm just giving her a reason to come back. So there's this massive push to cap our expectations on with the positive, and then call it good. But we don't understand is this will cause this massive despair in the world. Massive despair. And then we'll be frantically trying to suffocate that despair. Frantically. There could be martial law in the United States for sure. Because people may start acting out, you know, in all sorts of ways. So they will try to suffocate, the world will try to suffocate its despair in some way. Absolutely they will. This is what's coming very soon. Probably this month. And then that would get underway, the despair and the suffocation, the capping, the despair, the suffocation, and it goes into August and you know, gets worse and worse, and then it, you know, going through the rest of the year. You know, who knows what's going to happen. But we're working to minimize this. The trouble here, we're working to minimize it, so we're not stuck for sure that this. We're trying to back away from that. We're always free to back away, to choose something else, to choose once again. We're always free to choose once again. Always free to choose once again. Now, when you're in your despair of positivism, what can you do? Sometimes you'll feel just so uninspired. Just chant the name of a Dharma king. And even though you don't get any response, just keep doing it. That's what I did yesterday. Jamyan Choki. Jamyan Kensi Choki Lodro. 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 just or long champa, long champa, long champa, long champa. Or sometimes I say, Jesus Christ, long champa, Jesus Christ, long champa, Jesus Christ, long champa, Jesus Christ, long champa. Just chant that. Or slower if you want. Jesus Christ, long champa, Jesus Christ, long champa, Jesus Christ, long champa, Jesus Christ, long champa, and my ma, Rama Maharshi. Nandamayama Ramana, Nandamayama Ramana, Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, Nandamayama Ramana, Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, Nandamayama Ramana. You can chant like that. It's harder to rhyme Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro. Jam Yankensi Ramana, Jam Yankensi Ramana, Jam Yankensi Ramana. But you just use these mantras with the various Dharma kings. Sargadatta, is it one of our Dharma kings? Well, we may adopt him as one. It's moving in that direction. Nisargadatta. Nisargadatta Ramana, Anandamayama Nisargadatta, Anandamayama Nisargadatta, Anandamayama Nisargadatta, Anandamayama Nisargadatta, like that. Or you can just Longchenpa, Longchenpa. Now, usually, a lot of times I don't get immediate results from this, so you just have to trust it. Because when we're stuck in positivism, what a blindness that is, isn't it? What a blindness that is. So we're temporary blind. Just say, I'm blind with arrogance. I'm temporarily blind with arrogance right now. So Longchenpa, Longchenpa, Longchenpa. And what are you doing? You're trusting it. You're trusting in him. So I know you got my back. You Longchenpa, you've got my back. I know you've got my back. Longchenpa, you've got my back. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. You see, Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro, bring me back to the right flow. You could pray it that way. You can assert it or you can pray it. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro, I am back in the right flow. I never left the right flow. I never left it at all. And so right away, we're back to the super positive practice. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. So this is what I do. This is my advice. Yeah. Have to call upon the Dharma kings. Really, they have the presence of super positivity. So when we're temporarily blinded by arrogance, we need that to call upon the super positivity. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro brings me back to the right flow. I never left the right flow. And then immediately, I never left the right flow. No one has left the right flow. Nobody's left the flow of freedom. I've never left the flow. I've never left the flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro. I've never left the flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro. I have never left the flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro. I have never left the flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro. I have never left the flow. Jam Yankensi Choki Lodro. So blinded by arrogance, Longchenpa. Longchenpa, 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 Longchenpa. Now sometimes, you know, the despair, when we get blinded by arrogance, we feel despair, and we start analyzing our despair. Don't analyze this despair. Don't analyze. Assert. Chant. Mantra yoga. Jamyang Kenshi Choki Lodro. I am back in the right flow. You brought me back to the right flow. You bring me back to the right flow. Jamyang Kenshi Choki Lodro. You bring me back to the right flow. Long jumpa, Jesus Christ, long jumpa, Jesus Christ, long jumpa, Jesus Christ, long jumpa. Assert, 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 mantra yoga, guru yoga, guru mantra yoga, let us say, guru mantra yoga, Jesus Christ, long jumpa, guru mantra yoga, guru mantra yoga. Guru Mantra Yogi, Guru Mantra Para Yoga, Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Para, Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Super Mantra, Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Super Mantra, Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Super Mantra. Okay, there you go. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, Guru Yoga, Super Mantra. Wow. Yeah, I'm getting some ideas for Facebook. Facebook this. Facebook this, Guru, Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Super Mantra. Super positive mantra, Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Super positive mantra. Super mantra, yeah, absolutely. Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, Guru Yoga, Super Mantra. So this is very wowish. I mean, this is really cool. You know, what we're doing, very wowish what we're experiencing here. Very wowish. Very, very wowish. It's like, wow. Now again, when we have the wow, then we go back to the blindness of arrogance. Just Jesus Christ, Long Jampa. Jesus Christ, Long Jampa. These are just, you know, these are just Dharma kings. And when you say Dharma king, that says it all. They're absolutely super positivist. Absolute super positivists. Absolute super positivist. Jesus Christ, Long Jampa. Meaning, trust it. Trust it. Trust it. Trust it. There's not a shred of anything other than super positivism with Jesus Christ and Longchenpa, our Dharma kings. Not a shred. So absolutely trust it. In other words, they totally support our super positivist practice. Totally support it. They're totally supportive. Totally supportive. Which is why we need to turn to them, because you won't find those in positivists. You won't find them totally supportive. They might say, well, yeah, you know, a little bit of that, but let's not do too much. In other words, they cap it. They're capping. There's no cap with Jesus or Longchenpa or Dharma kings. There's no cap. They're totally super supportive. Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Long Jampa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. We can do it that way. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Like that. You can do your own, you can do your own things. You know, use your body. You can use your body to move. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive. Super supportive. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. However you want to do it, right? There isn't any right way to do it. You could do it. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Or Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. You know, any which way, you could sing the song. The outline of the song is there. You could harmonize it. If you're like me, you probably do something different because you want to harmonize. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. But it is good to get started on something like that. It's good to have at least a model to get you started. But that doesn't have to be the way you do it. Or I don't have to do it at all. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. You could do it this way. So, Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Right? There's no right way of doing it. Let's not get stuck in a positivist right way of doing it. There's many ways of doing it. Infinite ways, actually. And even not doing it is doing it. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Without any flaw. Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Various ways, right? Jesus Christ, long jump pa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive, without any flaw. But engage yourself and keep practicing so that you can pull yourself out of your arrogant blindness. Rally your will. It is a will. Remember, the path is instant. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. There is no path. There is no will. There's never been any will. No one's ever had any will. Does freedom have a will? Does it need a will? It is freedom. Isness is. We speak of will, rallying our will, of course. But the way to rally our will is to assert there is no will to rally. There is no will to rally. And we remind ourselves, we pull ourselves out of arrogance by calling upon the Dharma kings. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super positive, without any flaw. No practice is the practice. No practice is the practice. I've never had any practice. Okay, so, Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive. Without any flaw. Super positive. You can say super positive without any flaw also. So don't let anyone tell you there's some right way to do it. That's the positive approach. There's never been any right way. There's never been any right way. There's never been any right way. Never will be any right way. No right way is the 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 right way. And we fall back into arrogant blindness. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive, without any flaw, super supportive, or super supportive, without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive, without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive, without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive without any flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive without any flaw. That was nice. I like that. I felt, you know, however you feel, you can do it. And if it evokes the feeling, that's fine. Don't get caught up in yoga guru positivism and saying this is the way. You have to do it this way. Because what they're really doing is they're hooking you on their looks and their glamour and persona, their positiveness, and then making you think that this is the way. No way is the way. No way is the way. No way is the way. Be very careful of the glamorous yoga girls and yoga guys without rejecting them or being neither affirming or negating it, neither. Without accepting it nor suppressing it. Okay, with neither accepting it nor suppressing it. Be careful of those that say, this is the way. No way is the way, actually. And so we can practice in multiple ways like this. And know that it's you get hooked on the positiveness of their glamour. And then you think, okay, I've got this positive feeling. That's it. And then you've capped your expectations. And then you feel despair. And then suddenly you feel a craving for them. And then that's when you're in a codependency situation. You're trapped by the yoga girl guru. Yoga guy guru. There's an entrapment has happened there. No way is the way. No way is the way of no way. No way is the way of no way. There is no way is the way. So you do what feels best for you. Without going through a suppression routine, which is still suffocating your despair and capping it. So, in other words, don't be for it and don't be against it. Don't pursue it and don't suffocate the pursuit of it either. So, there isn't, every way is the right way. There is no right way of doing this. You can see there's multiple ways. So it's not like we have to categorize. There's infinite ways. So what are we doing cataloging this? All cataloging is ridiculous. There's always infinite ways present. Just be sure that whether you decide to do it this way or some other way or multiple ways, that you say, this, no way is the right way. No way is the right way. Because we're just, all we're doing is using this to get us back into super positive practice. That's all. It's just a means to an end. And it's up to you. That each one's unique. So whatever you want to do, just do it. But don't try to suppress some other doing of it. Okay, so neither... accepting nor suppressing any, you know, you just do what you feel that brings you out of your arrogant blindness, that instantly brings you out of it. The instant path is the only path there is. The instant path is the only path there is. And it's here right now. It's instant. The trap we're avoiding, we will avoid, is that there's a right way to cap our expectations. And if we cap it in the right way, we won't feel the despair. This is a lie. Okay, do not accept this in any way, no matter how glamorous the form is that comes to you. Any capping of our expectation, short of super positive here practice, actually, brings severe despair. It makes no difference what the graffiti is on the wall. Okay? You can have all these yoga girls on the wall. It makes no difference. The severe despair will be there and will try to suffocate it. People may try to suffocate it in beautiful spiritual graphics and artwork on Facebook, and they're gearing up for that. Actually, that won't work. I mean, you'll suffocate to some extent, but you'll feel suffocated, and so then more suffocation. You'll feel, I need more suffocation. I feel so suffocated. Well, the ego said, well, more suffocation. We capped it in the right way, so everything must be fine. It's just, you know, so and so more. So you end up compounding. It's like taking It's like you're on a bad drug trip, taking more drugs. Those people used to do that. They'd take drugs and they'd be on a bummer. And what would they do? They said, give me more drugs. And they'd end up in the emergency room or something. I mean, so this is what happens. You cap it, the expectations into positivism. Severe despair arises. You try to suffocate it. When that doesn't work, you try to suffocate it even more. There isn't any right way to cap our expectations. There is no right way. So, realizing this, no right way is the way to what? To instant practice. No right way is the way to instant practice. So deny any possibility that there's some right way to cap our practice at positivism. There is no right way. There's no way without despair. There is no way without despair. There's no way to cap it. Well, the software caps the video, unfortunately. Yeah, because but it's getting close to being capped. So, Jesus Christ, Longchenpa. Perfect practice without a flaw. Super perfect practice without a flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa. Perfect practice without a flaw. Yeah. Like that. No right way is the right way. No right way is the right way. No way is the way. No way is the way. No way is the way. Now remember, hands to hands. Don't put your hands on your face. It's important. There's intense itching now I'm having on my in my nose. Just an intense burning itch. No, no, no. Just let it stay there. It's amazing when you refuse to scratch the itch, what happens? It goes away. Don't scratch the itch of positivity. Don't scratch the itch of positivity. There's no right way to scratch it. You scratch a mosquito bite, what more? It itches even more. Right? Scratch the poison oak, it itches even more. Don't scratch the mosquito bite. Don't scratch the flea bite. Full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. Relax. Don't put any project on the body, any difficulty. There's never been any difficulty whatsoever. So there's nothing to project. No need to project on the body any difficulty. Very great, very great, very great, very great. Super great. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa. Super supportive, without a flaw. Jesus Christ, Longchenpa, super supportive, without a flaw.